Hello, my name is Brandon Mack, and I am doing my master's in applied science in biomedical engineering at Ryerson University. In the presentation, I'll be presenting our paper entitled Siamese Content Loss Networks for Highly Imbalanced Medical Image Segmentation. To begin, the clinical challenge tackled in this implementation is semantic segmentation of white matter heterotensities in MR images. Clinically, manual delineations provide the most information for quantitative analysis. However, these are very laborious tasks and are subject to high inter and intra-rater variability. A particular challenge to automatic segmentation is the inherent class imbalance due to the relative small size compared to the whole acquired image. As shown here, for a percentage of positive classes over whole acquired volumes, at most make up less than 1% of all voxels. This class imbalance can lead to issues during training as predictions tend to the negative class. Our contribution in this paper is that we propose a loss function that utilizes an auxiliary Siamese network to extract contextual information at multiple scales. Contextual information is extracted not only from binary mass of prediction ground truth, but also from the input image. Presented here is an overview of our proposed method. The generator is a unit-based encoder-decoder structure with the discriminator being a Siamese network. The setup is similar to a GANs, however, unlike a GANs, our proposed method does not train the discriminator, rather we utilize transfer learning opting to use the VGD19 network pre-trained on ImageNet as a feature extractor. For each training step, the segmentation produced by a generator is combined with the input image and fed into one path of the Siamese network. The anchor of the Siamese network is simply a combination of an input image with the corresponding ground truth. The weights of the discriminator are frozen, and the generator is updated only by the L2 norm between the feature vectors calculated by the discriminator. As mentioned, the generator is a unit-based architecture. Notably, although acquired MR images are 3D volumes, we opted to utilize a 2D architecture using axial images due to the relative discontinuous nature of WMHs, and to avoid having site thickness as a variable. With some additional changes, namely each block of the convolution are dense blocks, and we utilize leaky ReLU activations over ReLUs to avoid the dagging ReLU problems. For the discriminator, the architecture is a Siamese network. The predictions and ground truth masks are soft binaries to give values between 0.1 and 0.9, such that the regions are not zeroed out. These masks are then respectively combined with input images through multiplication. Since the images are single channel, they are concatenated themselves to create pseudo RGB images. Features are then extracted and flattened to create feature vectors and then compared using the L2 norm. For the features we extract, we utilize the early mass pooling layers of the VGG19 network. We iteratively tested different configurations through grid search and how this yielded the best results. The rationale for utilizing the VGG19 network was due to its relatively linear structure and a progressively increasing receptive field. And here we present a sample of our segmentations. We benchmarked our method by training the same generator with other state-of-the-art loss functions. We developed our method on the Mikai 2017 WMH Grand Challenge dataset, with 60 volumes released publicly, we reserved 6 as our holdout set. As seen in the top row, our method shows similar or better performances on the holdout set compared to the benchmark. However, when we cross-validate on an independent dataset of a different distribution, namely the volumes of the Canadian Atherosclerosis Imaging Network, we see our proposed method displaying greater generalizability, with significantly higher Dice scores and even in some cases significant portions that are not detected by other methods. In this figure, the issue of generalizability and rater agreement is highlighted by observing the dip in performance across all methods when validating on an independent Kane dataset. Again, we see a similar performance on data that is derived from the same dataset as training, but for the validation dataset, although our method does also suffer from the L domain problem as well, it is noted that the range of DSC similarity is never zero, showing that even in the worst case, there is some lesion being detected. To quantitate our effectiveness on highly imbalanced volumes, we calculated the density of positive classes over acquired volumes, organized them into bins shown here. Between methods, we compared the average volume differences of the predictions to the ground truth as percentages. As we see in the bins on the lower left, the average volume difference between other lesion loads are significantly lower for our proposed method. We see this trend for most bins, with the median performance being significantly lower than other methods and a lower range of error, highlighting a relative consistent performance regardless of the severity of class imbalance. To conclude, our proposed method utilizes a Siamese network to extract contextual and multi-scale information in order to optimize segmentation models. We found that our method allows for greater generalizability across datasets and allows for consistent performance across ranges of severity of class imbalance. For our future works, we plan to further investigate other configurations of the discriminator network to avoid the constraints of forcing images to be a pseudo-RGB. We have also attempted to unfreeze weights of the VGG19 network to further fine-tune using adversarial training through a min-max fashion. However, the results were unsatisfactory and more loss functions and gain setups will be investigated in the future. I'd like to thank my collaborators, and I would like to thank the MIDL organizers for this conference, and I'd like to thank you for listening.